Welcome to the Outlast Insane Mode Death-Defying Guide, where I guide you through the parts of Outlast where you can die, so that you know how to get through them without fail when you play the game on Insane Mode. Right now, I'm just loading the very beginning of the game so I can get started. There's nowhere to die for a while. The first place where you can die is in the security room the first time you're there. And I'll skip right to that right now. So here we are, first place to die. I just got the key card from the dead security guard and then got manhandled by the dude in the wheelchair. I'm heading back to the security room and I'm going to try to override security or whatever I'm gonna do. Father Martin, he's gonna turn off the power like a little jerk, and power's gonna go out, emergency lights are gonna come on, and then Chris Walker is gonna start heading this way, and if you don't hide, he will kill you, and if you come out of hiding too early, he will kill you. So the strategy to use here is to not let him kill you. That's usually your best bet of survival. Here it comes. Now, I've known it to be possible to... Ooh, I just got a note by accident. Oopsie. I know it's possible to leave and run out of here while he's... That's weird, he usually does that second. You know, scratch what I just said, because he didn't even look at the screens. I don't think. That was weird. Anyway, no matter what, I suggest wait until he leaves and goes down the hallway to the left and then run. Oh, he spotted me. Sometimes he doesn't spot you, but he spotted me this time. Just keep running, run down the stairs, and you're not safe until you squeeze through here. Now you're safe. That was actually probably the closest call I ever had. He's right there. But still, it's pretty easy. So that was the first part where you can die. The next part is right up ahead, so I'm gonna start that as a new video. Death-Defying Act number 2. We're in the basement, the flooded basement, in chapter 1. We have to turn the power back on. There's a variant down here who's going to try to whack the crap out of me with a stick. So I'm gonna go to the room on the right, turn on the circuit breaker here, run to the room on the left. He's gonna start banging on that door, turn on this circuit breaker, and then hide under the bed. Wait for him to show up. Here he comes. He should walk all the way to the circuit breaker. Yay, he actually did this time. Once he's over there, just run. Actually, I want him to see me. There we go. I want him to see me so that he's right on my tail when I go into the room, because I don't want to have to wait forever for him to come once I turn on the power. Just go in, close the door behind you, turn on the power. He's going to start knocking. Do not answer the door. Just hide in this locker. And he's already inside. If he were to not spot you when you first ran away, you'd be sitting in here forever. Okay, when he opens that locker, now. You run. Head back to the main room, hit the button, and then at that point you can turn off your camcorder. Just turn around, head through the door you came in, turn left, over the desk, turn right, and then through the crack. Once you're through here, you're safe. That's the end of Death-Defying Act number 2. Now just head back up to the security room and start working on the computer again. The next place to die, or to avoid dying, is in Chapter 2. I will see you there. Here we are in Chapter 2, where we have Death-Defying at number 3. We meet this dude saying to go down the drain, so we do. Then we turn around and head this way. Here's the dude that likes things to be quiet. He'll be a problem later, but not right now. We're just gonna keep going to this security room. There's a dude in here that's going to be a problem. Get his attention. There we go. Then lock him in, and then turn around and head all the way back. All the way over this table, then into this room. Leave the door open, and there's a bed right here. Just hide under this bed in this cell and wait. You're gonna wait for a pretty long time, but this dude that you just ran away from is gonna come all the way down this hallway and then go through the gate that leads to the staircase. And once he does that, he is not gonna be a problem. So this is the safest way to avoid death. You'll hear him go through the gate, so that's what you're waiting for. Gonna wait for him to open and close the gate. You'll definitely hear it. There it is. That was the sound. So now you can run. He went through here. He's not gonna be a problem anymore. But this dude will be a problem after we hit the button in the security room. So we're gonna hit this button. This guy is now gonna get in our way, and he will hit you once. Right now. Just keep running. So long as you keep running and don't let him hit you a second time, you're good. It's impossible to avoid that first hit, though. But once you've done that, you're good. That is the end of Death-Defying Act number 3. Here we are, Death-Defying Act number 4. I had crawled through this window, turned here, I already went down this hallway and picked up the key card to go into the showers. The nudie brothers, Dick and Wang, are going to be in here. You don't need the night vision, but I'm gonna reload my battery. They're going to try to get you on this walkway here. Just so you can see them walking toward you. Just jump out this first window and shimmy all the way here. Do not go through that window. Just keep going. You can hear them talking about you. And then climb back in through this window. There they are. And once you get through here, I don't think they actually ever chase you, but if you get near them, they will kill you in one hit. So that is why that's a death-defying part. I have two shadows. Weird. So that is the end of that. The next part is actually right up ahead. I'm just going to include that in this video. It's right here. Chris Walker is gonna come through here. He's gonna start banging on here. You're gonna be like, oh crap, what do I do? This freaking door's locked. And then you're like, oh. Oh crap. So yeah, you've got all the time in the world to do this though. Especially since I opened that gate ahead of time. Now he's going to burst through that door, just run through here, I already opened this. And then, boom! So that just happened. And you were still not out of harm's way. Death-Defying Act number whatever's next is right now. Still have to avoid Chris. Because he is going to jump down right there. We're just gonna run right to him, jump over the railing from the staircase, and then make a run for it. And it'll work. I don't know. He's way over there. I mean, you've got all the time in the world now, but you're not out of harm's way. Even after squeezing through here, you're still not out of harm's way until you go through here. Hi. Now you're safe. So that was 3 death-defying acts in a row. I'm glad that's out of the way. This is the final death-defying act for Chapter 2. This is right after where we escaped Chris Walker. We came in through that door there. Then I climbed up onto this ledge and came all over this way. There is a dude up on the third floor in the shadows. I'll point him out with this. He is right there. He will try to kill you when you get near him, so just run past him. And he's yelling at me. If you walk by him, he will hit you. If you let him hit you twice, he will die. Oh crap, that scared me for some reason. Forgot about you. He can kill you. That's why I'm mentioning this. So just run right past him. That's all there is to it. And that is the end of all the death-defying acts for Chapter 2. There were 6 of them this time. 2 in the first chapter, 6... I have trouble saying that sound. 1 more than 5 in this chapter. And now for Chapter 3. Here we are at the very, very beginning of Chapter 3. This chapter starts with, well, with the wall rider going right by you if you had night vision on. But it starts with a large puzzle chase hide-and-go-seek thing with Chris Walker right here. As soon as you enter, run, stay to the right, and then go down the female ward tunnel. Jump over this, go right, go through here, close the door, turn on the valve, then hide behind the shelves on your right. Wait for Chris to barge in. I'm so glad I'm not doing this using text like I already did. I already made Chapter 3 for this and took forever. This is so much easier. Oh, come on, Chris, hurry up. Oh, I think he heard me. Wait for him to head over to the lockers on the opposite side of the room. Once he's, like, sort of out of sight in the fog, just... Ooh, he actually spotted me. He usually doesn't spot me. Okay, just... He's slowish, so just run all the way. Remember, there's a jump right there. Don't forget to jump over that. Just run all the way through this tunnel if you have time. If not, go to the left. You're not actually truly safe until you squeeze through here, though. You cannot go through here. So, go ahead and turn on this valve. And now you can head back to the ladder. Now this next part can be tricky, and then it cannot, depending on what Chris decides to do. Let's see where he goes. He's gonna come from the right, and then just hang back. Don't get too far towards the tunnel's entrance, or else he will grab you and kill you. Is he going to right, or is he gonna go straight? Please go right, please go right, please go right. Ah, damn it. Well, I guess it's better that I describe how to go through here. Alright, since he's going straight, which is where I have to go... Wow, it got foggy in here. I'm going to slowly follow him while remaining crouched. I'm going to stay on the right side of the tunnel. So that I'm not walking through the water making noise. And once he's out of view, I can get up and walk slowly forward, jump over this thing, And once he starts heading down that tunnel, I have time to run for it to the ladder. And I should be dead.
Yep.
So that large sequence was Death-Defying at number 9. And you won't have another one for quite a while, I think. And I think it's another one involving Chris in the pitch black flooded section. Let's see. So this is Death-Defying at number 10. Probably one of the more likely places for you to die during your run on insane mode. This is the flooded section. I already navigated all the way to this tunnel. Once I go through here, Chris Walter will appear, and you have to find your way to the ladder in pitch black without him finding you, because he can run a lot faster than you in the water. I'm going to go ahead and reload my battery and start. Now, there are different ways to approach this. You can either go to the left, or you can go to the right. I'm going to go to the left this time. And don't rush this. You can actually, like, do that. Hold L1, and you'll go a little faster through the water. But I'm just going to walk. And stay to the left. Chris Walker is going to be moving around in the center. We are heading there, ultimately. But I'm going to stay to the left. Now, if you do go to the left, then what you're going to need to do is jump straight onto the catwalk from the water. If you were to have gone to the right, then you would go up a ways and then move towards the center until you see the staircase that leads up to the catwalk. But that would, if I were to try to get to the staircase from the left, it's more likely I would encounter Chris. So once this is almost directly to your right, just kind of run for it. Then jump up to the catwalk. As soon as you're up here, he will come after you. So turn around, jump to the ladder. Make sure you make that jump, even though it is possible to fail it and jump back onto the catwalk, and then jump up here again without dying. I've done that, but it's best if you make that on your first try. So don't rush it too much. Make sure you did the jump. Now the next Death-Defying act is right here. I'm gonna just go right ahead into it. As soon as he's done come after you, just loop him through here. There might have been a battery right there on the floor, but don't bother getting it. Then turn left, right, left, left, right, and then left. And he won't keep chasing you once you're down here. That was it for chapter 3. Next is the longest chapter in the game. Maybe, maybe not. Female Ward's kind of long too. But it's the chapter with Dr. Trader, so that one is going to be very interesting. The first Death-Defying act in chapter 4 is a somewhat lengthy chase sequence. Three guys are going to be chasing you all throughout the male ward. And you got to make sure you know where you're going, you got to make sure you're closing the right doors with you on the right side of them, and blocking the right doors, and just making all the right moves, or else you're screwed. So this is where it starts. This dude's gonna start yelling. Those two guys are gonna try to bust through the door. You have to push this unit aside, then open this door, close it behind you. Don't go through this door. There's a dude there. Go through this door. Close this door and do push this unit in front of the door, because you're gonna need time to move the unit away from the other door here. Now go left, jump over this table, follow the blood into here, close this door, but you don't need to bother pushing that thing in front of it. You can just go straight up to the vent. Once you drop down to left, then right, over, left, left, over, and then make this jump.
You slippery little whore.
Salty language. It's not over yet, though. They're gonna start barging through that door, so go right, then right, and jump over here and through the, whatever that's called, I forgot. I learned that word in Toy Story 3. Alright, keep going. Don't dwaddle, whatever that word is, like I just did. Go through here, close the door behind you.
Who's down there? You're not one
and
of them, are you? Quick,
this
get in the
helpful little dude's gonna help you escape, so. Once you're in here, you're safe, or at least so you think. But guess what? You get to meet Dr. Trader. And the next death-defying act is escaping his custody. And that is also a somewhat lengthy scene. I'll get right to it. So here we are after getting to meet Dr. Trader, who just cut off my left ring finger and right index finger. Jerk. And I'm gonna throw it. Oh, that's just nasty. So now I've gotta get the out of here. Go through here. And then through here. This dude's gonna start talking. I'm just gonna hide out in this little corner. And wait for a traitor. I'm yawning. To come in. And when he does come in, let him pretty much go all the way to the executive on the table. So that he doesn't spot you when you leave. Now it's safe to go. So, I think he spotted me. Yep! Oh crap. Oh crap. Jump through here. That was weird. Okay, so that was not ideal. Usually you don't want him to spot you, but once you make it through that vent, you're safe. Now once you come down here, push this unit aside now, so that it's already out of the way. What? Oh shit. You freaking spotted me then. Oh god. Okay, so this is like the worst playthrough of this part I've ever done. Where are you gonna go? This is gonna be very on my feet. I've never done this like this before. What I should have done is I should not have walked backwards when I came down here. Oh shit, he's right there. Where's he going? How did he get there? This is not going well. Okay, I don't know what I'm planning to accomplish from here. Maybe I can loop him around this thing. Let's see. Otherwise, I'm just gonna have to start over. Ah, I couldn't close that. Okay, so I know he's behind me. I'm just gonna jump down here. Run this way. I almost want to start over because this is all messed up. When you're in here, don't look at the guy on the brightly lit table, or he will start yelling and Trader will come after you. Okay, that's not a good sound. Oh crap, he's right there. Hell yeah! In your face, you little... Oh crap. I forgot what to do. Oh yeah, the vent. Okay, this is the worst walkthrough ever! Almost feel like just redoing this whole thing. God. But at least it shows how you can still mess up and not die. It's a pretty forgiving game in that sense. This part's easier. I've never messed up here. Grab the key. So start barging in through that door. Just close this door and then hide in this corner just like the first time. Only he shouldn't see me this time. He's never seen me at this part. Here he comes. You should be good to go right now. See? Didn't see me. Every time. Go left, and then... Even though he's never seen me, I always move this thing out of the way right now while I'm thinking about it. Or, you know, when I first got to it. So that in case he does see me, I don't have to worry about that being in the way. So, yeah, he's gonna attack you one more time. There's nothing you have to do here, though. This is sort of a cutscene. Once you start the elevator, you are in the clear, and Dr. Trader will not be a problem anymore. That is the end of Dr. Trader. So, this is not, however, the end of the male ward chapter. There is still plenty left, and all the death-defying acts that are left mainly involve Chris. So I'll get right to the next one, which takes place in this little sprinkler puzzle. So this next death-defying act, I don't know what number this is, I've lost count. This is going to take place right after you leave this burning cafeteria. Now, I'm not going to count dying in here by burning to be a death-defying act. Just don't touch the fire and you'll be fine. I don't even know if you can die. I'm not going to try it, but I've never died because I'm not that stupid. So once you leave, go left and go through this crack. Up ahead is another puzzle involving Chris, just like the one in the sewer. You're gonna have to, push this at the end. But once you're in here and you see that shadow, just keep running and turn right. Turn right here. Go ahead and close this door. It's not absolutely necessary, but I prefer to close it. Then turn on the valve. And there's all sorts of ways to go about this part. This is what I do. I go to this locker in the back. Ooh, that was close timing. And he... yawning. He's, what the hell? He's never come this close before. Wow. Where's he going? This is so weird. Everything is happening differently. I'm not quite sure what to do. I'm used to him just walking in a few steps and then going back out. He went all the way in. I'm just gonna let him walk all the way out again. Because that's what I'm used to. You better hurry the F up. Because I have to pee and there's like no bathroom in this locker. So, once he leaves, you can exit the locker. Oh shit. Okay, that just happened. Pretend that didn't happen. For one thing, I kept getting caught on the door. I was trying to go through the door, and it wouldn't let me. So, let's try this again. That's a good example of how to F this up. I'm gonna try this again. Hopefully he's actually gonna do what I'm used to. I don't know what makes it different. I'm gonna do the left locker this time. Took longer to get in here this time. See, this is what I'm used to. He just stops, looks around, comes in a few more steps. Then turns around. There we go. That's what I need. And then once he leaves, exit here. Never, ever hit the sprint button during this part. That's what made him come back last time. Then wait here for him to start banging on a door. You'll feel it. And he does, right there. Actually, you didn't feel it, but you'll hear it. When he does, go around. If you need a battery, there's one right here. But be quick about it. Then go left and through this crack. If you're really quick, he won't even see you. But if he does, that's fine. You'll have plenty of time. Here's Mr. Ducky. Turn on this valve. Now comes the part where I've died the most when practicing this. The key here is to be extremely quick. So just run. Wait a minute. He hasn't even spotted me. Wow, that's never happened. He didn't even spot me. Awesome. Alright, well, if he spots you, just try not to die, but hopefully you'll end up doing what I just did. That was weird. That's never happened before. So that was the end of Death-Defying that number whatever. I need to recount these videos, find out what number I'm on. The next one is in the next chapter. No, wait. No, the next chapter is the courtyard. You can't die in the courtyard. So you won't die again until the female lord. So that's a long time in the future. I'll get right to it. Okay, so this is the female lord chapter. This is the first Death-Defying act in the chapter. It's very, very easy to remember this one. It's hard to remember what to do, but you never forget the whole trying to do the fuses thing to get the key being held by this contortionist here. This is probably the hardest part in the game. At least it was for me when I was practicing it. I died maybe 7 times in nightmare mode, just trying to get through it before I found a winning formula. And the first fuse is through here. The other two are through here. You want to get this one first. Head down here. By the way, we'll be up there later. Yeah, we'll be right there, and we'll be crossing over there later. Go through here, leave this door open, because you're gonna want to shut the dude in when he follows you into here. Grab the fuse, and then hide under this bed. And wait for this dude with the stick to walk in here. Here he comes. See where he goes. He should go, yes, that way. Give him time to move a little farther. Okay. Now run out and shut the door. Huh. He didn't even spot me that time. He usually spots me, but he didn't that time. I don't think that's gonna be a problem anymore. No, I feel him. He's banging on the door. So now that we got the first fuse, go down to get the next fuse. When you get to the wheelchair, turn left. The next fuse is in this room. This is the one you want to do next. This dude, once you grab the fuse, will start walking towards you. If you need a battery, there's one right here. He doesn't run after you, just watch, but he's got a really sharp something there. Lock him in. Then head straight across, past the wheelchair, to the other fuse. I'm gonna reload my battery. There's another battery right here. A lot of batteries in this section. Close this door. But you don't have to block it. Then... oh, there's a battery there if you need it, but I don't need it. Actually, I don't even think you need to close this door. Somebody should be coming. Eventually. Stickman, probably. Here he comes. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Okay, that might have been the reason why you needed to close the door. Because when you close a door, they like to come break it down. No matter where they are, they like to just come and break it down. So I'm going to wait for that to happen. Oh, I am yawning so much. It's early in the morning. I haven't had coffee yet. I'm trying to get as much of this done as I can. If I wait any longer, I'm gonna need to get that battery. Oh. Yes, that is something I should mention. Grab the fuse, that usually helps. Now they should start coming. Doi. That was a here it comes. I thought I just heard him. Gonna reload and grab the new battery. Are you coming or not? I see him. Here he comes. I'm gonna loop him around this table. That's why I'm standing back here. Man, he sure does take his time. Here he comes, finally. Now, it's really dark in here, so he doesn't see you yet. Once he gets closer... which way do you want to go? Left, right? Where the hell are you going? Hey, get back here. Chase me, you little twit. No. There you go. Loop him around the table. It's behind me. Jump over this bed. At the wheelchair, turn left. And then close this door. Haha. Keep running. There's another door here if you want to close it. It's pretty easy to miss, though. And another door here. That should give you plenty of time to do whatever you want. Play game of cards, I don't know. Put the fuses in, hit the button. That's gonna open, but the contortionist is gonna fall. No! So you gotta go back down to the laundry room on the first floor where you were earlier. You didn't see it in this video because I started on the second floor. I'm gonna keep recording because there's another dude down here that was there. He disappeared now. He'll show up again, though, and he can kill you if you don't run. Here's our handy-dandy contortionist with the key.
Got it.
Now this dude should show up. Here he comes. He's gonna come through, just run past him, run up the steps, make this jump, and at this point you are home free. That's all there is to it. That was pretty much the hardest part in the game, at least to me, to figure out, at least. So, from now on, it should be pretty easy. This Death-Defying act is extremely easy. This is where you meet the Nudie Brothers in this room. You'll come across this room with an arrow pointing to it, and the door's partially cracked. Don't turn off the camera to save power while I explain this. Now, I'm sure the first time you played through this, you probably died. Or at least they chase you. But I know a way to get through this in just a few seconds without any problem. Rather than really explain it, I'm just gonna have you watch. Just watch what I do. And that's it. You're done. You're safe. You, as soon as they close the door, run through, go to the right, head through the door on the far side, and jump over here. That's all there is to it, and they don't even see you. They're that stupid. That was so much more complicated the first time I played this. The next Death-Defying act will be after you lose the camera. I'm going to go ahead and show you losing the camera now. And then I'll start the next video after you find it, because once you find it, you're gonna start getting chased by three freaky looking dudes. And I'll show you how to get backed up to here without dying. Gravity is a bitch. Let's go find that camera. So I've made my way downstairs. Up ahead is a blue light coming from the screen of my camera that fell down to there. And you cannot die on your way to the camera, but you sure can die once you get the camera. So jump over this counter thing, head straight for the light. Still can't die yet. Can't die till you grab the camera. When you get to the table, go around to the right of it and grab your camera from the table. When you turn left, you're gonna see some guys. As soon as you do, run all the way back to where you came from. Ready? Go. You actually don't need the camcorder's night vision for this, since you were able to make it down here without it. You're gonna go around this shelf, turn left, then right, then left, then left, then right. Over this, left, left, and up over the lockers. Once you're up here, you are safe. Now, while I've got you, I'm gonna go ahead and mention this battery that you may have spotted on your way down. The battery location right here if you need it. I'm gonna go ahead and just grab this myself. Alright, that is the end of that little fun chase. I don't know if I've ever died on that one. I'm just gonna go ahead and mention this one. I usually don't mention parts where you can fail a fall, but since I failed this fall while playing on insane mode, and it was so frustrating since I was so close to the end, I'm gonna go ahead and mention this. When you get to the third floor and you come to this, wait for it to do that. Don't just dash through and jump before it finishes collapsing, or else you will die. Like I did. And it was just infuriating. So once it falls, then you can sprint and jump, and you'll make the fall. And that is the... Only one way. That is quite a hair loop. That is the end of the Female Ward chapter. I do believe that was shorter than the Male Ward chapter. Next is the return to the administration block. This involves Chris Walker two times, I think, and also the Nudie Brothers in the theater. And I think that's it. It's a pretty easy chapter, if you know where to go. This is, like, right after where I just stopped the last one. I'm about to start the seventh chapter, Return to the Administration Block. I have yet to see the loading screen because I want to talk to you first. Alright. As soon as the chapter starts, just start sprinting forward. Chris Walker's going to appear on the other end of the hallway. You want to go through the room on the left that's cracked open, right here. Jump on the desk and through the vent. If you were as quick about it as I was, he won't even see you. Once you're through here, you're in the clear. This next death-defying act is in the theater. Once you get the key, and you head back down into the main area, one of the Nudie Brothers, either Dick or Wang, I don't know who, I never actually assigned a particular name to either one, he's gonna start barging in right here. Hide right here, just right here in the open next to the door, and little bear butt here will not even see you. You can go ahead and just run past him, and you're good. That's all there is to it, but he can kill you if he spots you. Here's his brother. This is the other Nudie Brother. An elephant between his legs. That's all there is to it. I think the next death-defying act involves your final death-defying encounter with Chris Walker. So, this next death-defying act happens right after Father Martin sets himself on fire. Don't forget to grab the key that he gives you. Dick and Wayne are gonna let you out. They're not gonna be a problem anymore. Yeah, I know you don't like that. When you leave the chapel, go to the right and jump into this vent. When you come out the other side, Chris Walker is going to come after you. And there's probably different ways to approach this one, but this is how I do it. When he first appears, head right. Head all the way to the end. Go through this room on your left and stand over here. He's going to start barging into the other door because he's stupid. And when he does, let him come your ways a little, then run. You don't want him right by the open door when you walked out, or else he'll grab you right there. Turn right at the T. We're now heading where he came from. Head into here. Almost didn't make it. We've been here before. Jump onto the vending machine and up into the vent. And once you're up here, you are safe and Chris Walker will never bother you again. Well, at least in a way that you can die. We'll see him one more time, though. That is the end of the Return to the Administration Block chapter. There's one more chapter left, and it all involves the Wall Rider. You'll finally be meeting the Wall Rider. Luckily, the Wall Rider can hit you once without killing you. And here we go. We are going down into the lab. Let's go meet that Wall Rider. So your first encounter with the Wall Rider occurs when you are so close to finally leaving this place. There's the exit. It's daylight. That's the door you need to go through. It's right around the corner. So you're gonna head that way. The delivery exit. Dark in here, but when you approach that door, little dipshit Wall Rider starts to come after you, so you have to go backwards and head all the way back where he came from. He's behind you, even though you can't see him without night vision.
Just run through these doors. Once you're through these doors, you should be screwed. It's about time he vented his anger. Ha. Ha ha. Okay, that was lame. And that is the last you'll ever see of Chris Walker. Just wave goodbye. It's been nice knowing you, Chris. Now we have to take care of Billy, the wall rider. So after talking to the supposedly dead Dr. Wernicke, you're gonna head through this door here that closes behind you. And just head straight. We're heading to the morphogenic engine chambers. Wall Rider's gonna show up right there. Just head right past him, through this door. Don't bother closing anything behind you. Head through here. And then up the stairs. And then you will be safe once you go through this. And that's all there is to it for that part. However, I'm gonna go ahead and roll right into the final Death-Defying act, the final encounter with the Wall Rider, right here in the morphogenic engine room. This will be your first and only chance to actually kill someone in this game. Billy. You're gonna kill Billy because he is the host of the Wall Rider. Poor Billy. So you go to the right. You're gonna turn off his life support fluid reservoirs. And when you do, the Wall Rider's gonna come after you. So this whole part is actually very, very easy. If you just keep running, you'll be fine. You usually know where to go. It's pretty intuitive. You're gonna turn off the valve that says do not turn off the valve, which is just stupid. How dare you put a valve there and tell me not to turn it off? It's just the way of nature. If I see a valve, I'm turning it. So he's somewhere. Don't even bother looking for him. Just know that he's always behind you. You never have to loop him or anything. He'll always be behind you. You'll always have plenty of time to get where you're going, so long as you keep running. Now that we've done that step, we go across to the other side, to the sub-lab generator. Squeeze through here. And we're gonna have to go way the hell up there. It's gonna take a while. But he's still behind you, so that's why we're still running. He's always chasing you. Make sure you make this jump. I think I failed it the very first time I played it. Make sure you make that jump. Turn right on the catwalk. You can use night vision here. Go around, and you'll be safe once you're in here. But then he'll start chasing you again once you're out. So I'm gonna keep rolling. Head out to this panel. Turn off his, life pod failsafe. No, wait, that's what we're doing next. He's gonna chase you again after you leave here. He's actually gonna, you already know this is gonna happen. He's gonna grab you in midair when you try to make that jump again. It scares me every time. because it makes me think I failed the jump. Ugh. Every time. He's gonna twirl you around like a baton, then drop you, and somehow you live. And you can still run, so just run back to the main room. Luckily, you didn't have to go all the way down the stairs. Squeeze through here. And just slap down that hand. Just slap the computer. Slap it dead. Slap. And that is it. Once you get to this point, you win. Well, you as a player win. You as Miles Upshur, the investigative reporter, you just entered a circle of hell. So if you just made it this far on insane mode, you just got the trophy. Or at least you'll probably get the trophy once you... that looked excruciating. You'll probably get the trophy once you read the credits. Thank you for following along with my guide. I'm sure it was not the best. I wasn't doing that great, but at least I found ways to make it through. Just like the camera survived, too. I'll also be making a guide for the collectibles, the notes and the documents. I'll be doing a complete playthrough on Nightmare difficulty, collecting all documents and notes, and never dying. Just one complete, comprehensive playthrough. That's also done sort of as a speed run. I'll be doing that sometime in the near future. I'm going to keep going. There's one more death-defying act to witness. It's inevitable, but it is a death-defying act in the technical sense, probably more so than anything else. This symbol reminds me of Treyarch. Just keep limping. Come on, Miles, you can do it! Move them legs. And here we are. Congratulations. I hope you enjoyed this game as much as I did. I'll also be doing an insane mode walkthrough and comprehensive walkthrough for the Whistleblower DLC, which is even cooler and more grotesque. That will be very fun. I will see you later. Thanks for watching.